Introduction to Current Transformers, Part 6. In Part 5, we connected three CTs in Delta and showed how the currents would circulate for the Delta connection. In Part 6, we're going to draw the current transformer model and show the voltages, currents, and impedances that are associated with the CT model. Okay, so to begin, we're going to draw two windings. Here's our primary winding, and here is our secondary winding. Okay, so right after the secondary winding, we're going to draw what we call a magnetization branch. So in our magnetization branch, we have this resistor here, which we're going to call RC. And then we have this reactance here, which we're going to call ZE, connected like that. And then we're going to have a resistor here, which we're going to call R secondary. And then another reactance here, which we're gonna call J, and then consider this as our CT terminal, or the X1 terminal. Similarly, we're going to have an X2 terminal on the secondary side, and then the terminals are connected to what we call a burden. Label it as a B. Okay, so let's now annotate our currents. So this current here, we're gonna call this IST, okay? And then this current right here, we're gonna call this current IS, which is the same current that's flowing through our burden, IS, okay? And then we're going to zoom in and call this current here IE, this current I loss, and this current IM, okay? And then for our voltages, we're gonna call this voltage here VS, which is measured across a winding, and we're going to call this VB, which is measured across the secondary terminals. And then of course we have the primary voltage, which is measured across the primary winding, and notice how we have a single turn on the primary side. And then of course we also have the primary current. Okay, so this is the simplified CT model that we're going to analyze in part 6. Okay, so first of all, let's label these currents, okay? IP is obviously the primary current that's flowing through our primary winding. IST is our secondary total current, which equals IS plus IE. IE is our excitation current, which is a non-linear value and is going to change based off of our secondary flux. This is going to be explained later, but the excitation current is equal to I loss plus IM. So let's make this a little bit smaller. Okay, I loss is the current required to supply the core losses of the transformer. IM, which is this current here, that is our magnetization current, which is really a non-linear value, and that's the value that's proportional to the secondary flux. And lastly, you will have IS. Now remember, IS is this current here, which is going to our burden and our relays and our meters and anything that's actually connected to the CT terminal. Okay, and that's our secondary current. Okay, now let's move on to our voltages. So VP is our primary voltage. VS is our secondary voltage. The secondary voltage is really described as a voltage across this magnetization branch, which is a very important voltage, okay? And then, of course, VB is our voltage across the burden. So our burden, which is also very important. Oftentimes, VS and VB are used interchangeably, but they should not. They're two different voltages. Okay, let's now move on to our impedances. So RC is a resistor required to model the losses of the core. ZE is the magnetization impedance. Now this is the impedance that changes with respect to the secondary flux of the transformer. R secondary is actually the resistance of the coil per turn. So each turn has a resistance that's associated to it. And R secondary models that resistance. Secondary winding resistance. And this value will change based on the number of turns that you have on the secondary side, which is quite obvious. Okay, so JXL is the leakage reactant. And that's the small amount of flux that will not pass through the secondary winding. So it's the flux that's not actually reaching the core. So that is modeled by this particular impedance. Okay. And then lastly, our most important impedance is called the B, which is the burden, which is essentially everything, all of the impedances that are connected from this X1 terminal to the X2 terminal. So that includes the lead impedance, any sort of relay impedance. If we have series of relays that are all connected together, then all of those impedances are added up and are considered the burden of the current transformer. So let's resize this a little bit to make it fit. Okay, so we've explained all of the values that are associated with modeling a current transformer, right? We looked at the primary current, the primary voltage, the secondary voltage, which is actually measured across this magnetization branch, the total secondary current, which is the current that's equal to this exciting current, plus the secondary current that's actually going through the burden. We looked at this RC value, which represents the core losses of the actual transformer, the ZE value, which is the magnetization impedance, R secondary value, which is the secondary winding resistance, the JXL, which is the leakage reactance, and the burden. And we looked at all of these currents, okay? So I kept on saying that this ZE value is really non-linear, which means it's going to change based off of the secondary flux. And remember that the secondary flux is really controlling the secondary voltage. So what we're actually saying is that this ZE value is directly proportional to the secondary voltage value. And during normal operating conditions, we should expect this magnetization branch to be really high. So this magnetization branch should be, you know, 1,000 ohms to 10,000 ohms. So during normal operating conditions and steady state conditions, this magnetization impedance should be really, really high. So this exciting current should be very, very low. The total secondary current should closely equal the secondary current. And remember, for a current transformer, the whole purpose of it, the secondary current is directly proportional to the primary current based off of the current transformer ratio. So can you imagine what this excitation current really implies? Well, this simply implies the errors of a current transformers. And those errors are often called this saturation, right? So we hear that a lot. The current transformer is going to saturate. What's the limit of the saturation point? So this point, this saturation, or this errors of a current transformer, that's modeled by this excitation current that's flowing through this magnetization branch, and that's a nonlinear value. So in part 7, we're going to talk about saturation, but from a CT model's perspective. We're going to correlate saturation with this excitation current as well as this secondary voltage. And we're gonna see how the burden plays a role in all of that. This module was brought to you by GeneralPack.com, making protection, automation, and controls intuitive.